this is to end in fire. Then we shall all burn together. Watch the flames climb high into the night. Calling our father, oh, Simba, and we will watch the flames burn over and on the mountainside. High. We should die tonight, we should all die together. Raise a glass of wine for the last time. Cold in our father, oh, prepare as we will watch the flames burn over and on the mountainside. Desolation comes upon the sky. Now I see fire inside the mountain, I see fire. In the trees, I see fire. Hollow souls, I see fire. Blood in the breeze. If I hope that you remember me.
Good morning, everyone. I'm DJ Spector. I literally just woke up like an hour ago. So I look like this when I wake up after celebrating the Blackhawks winning last night against the St. Louis Blues. What do I do on Sunday mornings? I know my schedule says I normally stream in the evening, but I think I just need to change that because I just stream kind of anytime I can on Sundays. And let me turn the music down. What this is a big contrast to my Thursday stream, where I tend to go a little bit crazy. This week's Thursday content was a little mellow, but normally it can go off the rails. So anyway, what this is the down tempo sessions. Basically, we listen to chill music, and I try to get my mic to sound loud enough that people can hear me. Meanwhile, there's a cat in my lap, and I'm not kidding. There's an actual cat in my lap, see? But anyway, it's basically where what I do is I chill. There's gonna be no shouting. Not usually, anyway. I mean, there probably is some shouting when I get angry. Like, if I really start sucking at a game. But I try to play games that don't involve me yelling. So I play chill games. Last week, I did Ori and the Blind Forest, which I'm still gonna continue my playthrough of that today. Today I'm gonna do Portal to start with. So Portal is a puzzle game built out of the Half-Life 2 Source Engine. It actually was, ironically, if you actually launch Portal, it doesn't show up as portal.exe in your process list. It shows up as Half-Life 2. It just says hl2.exe, so in that sense, it's kind of funny. But anyway, so that's what we do. Down-tempo sessions is chill time. It's where people can sit back, relax, enjoy what I'm going to do. And I got to actually launch this game here, so we'll get started. I have to launch the game and then hope it stays launched. That's really loud. How do I get out of this? Okay. That is astoundingly loud in my ears. It's loud. Very loud. Okay. I'm gonna turn down the volume on this because it is extremely loud, and I don't think we all need to be deafened. Okay, let me find another chill song here. I need to move this down so it's out of the way so I'm not like getting epilepsy from my own visualizations there. I don't have any of my songs marked as chill, which is kind of the problem. We'll do this one. Alright. So, let me go find Portal here. Get the sounds of this. That is extremely loud. This audio, game volume, and half. Music volume, and half. Yeah, it's a little bit more tolerable. So, we'll put it all the way down here. There we go. Actually, I don't think I need the music at all. There we go. Alright. So, if you guys never played Portal, then here's Portal. I don't know what else to say. Although I gotta get this on my main screen here though. I don't have it added. Portal. There's gonna show up. Okay, there it is. Let's get this so that all the other elements. Let's get that one again. There it is. There. There we go. Alright. I think my girlfriend was playing this long ago, but I don't want to overwrite what she's doing. You know what? Whatever, I'll just start a new game. Chess Chamber Zero. I like how you can look here and it says Portal Test Sequence. It shows you all the different tests.
Hello, and again.
Hold on. This is funny. This is GLaDOS.
Aided Enrichment Center. We hope your brief detention in the relaxation vault has been a pleasant one. Your specimen has been processed, and we are now ready to begin the test proper. Before we start, however, keep in mind that although fun and learning are the primary goals of all Enrichment Center activities, serious injuries may occur. For your own safety, and the safety of others, please refrain from...
Por favor, por donde...
Turn back. The portal will open in 3, 2, 1.
And you can see here where you can see where she's got like some sort of leg extensions that she uses to jump. So this is Chell, or supposed to be Chell, the main character in Portal. The thing is though that I actually think this is a take on Alex Vance from Half-Life 2, and that this is what she eventually looks like, because you never really get a clear look at her face, right? And people were like, well, there was no Half-Life Episode 3, right? And I'm like, no, actually my theory is that Portal is Half-Life Episode 3, because if you think about it, you have the gravity gun in Half-Life Episode 2, right? And, well, actually, you got the gravity gun through the end of the original Half-Life, plus all of Half-Life Episode 1 and Episode 2, the two expansions. However, what I do believe happened is that if you think about it, that they end up, like, there's, like, some space-time stuff that goes on in Half-Life 2 that's really crazy. I mean, like, at some point, time is stopped. You're plucked from the timeline and put someplace else. So, whatever. The point is that I believe that this is the third one, and just no one understood that. There's a camera watching me, because that's cute.
Excellent. Please proceed into the chamber lock after completing each test. First, however, note the incandescent particle field across the exit. This Aperture Science material emancipation grill will vaporize any unauthorized equipment that passes through it. For instance, the Aperture Science weighted storage cube.
There's something up with my audio. Like, I can only hear out of one ear. Are you guys having that? Are you guys only getting sound out of, like, the left channel or the right-hand channel here? Hey, Kimari, what's up? Because I'm getting sound only out of one channel here, which is weird. Like, I'm getting it a little bit out of the left, but it's, like, almost all the sound is out of the right channel. I don't know what it is. Maybe something in the audio. Options, audio. You gotta try to fight. No, that didn't help. Let me just try. Put in just. I'll just try headphones. No, it didn't actually help either. Dang, there's something up with the audio with this. Alright, let me put it back on 7.1, even though XSplit technically doesn't support it. Okay. Alright. Let me save this real quick here. And I'm gonna reload the game because I think there's something up with the audio. Oh, you hear fine out of both ears? Okay, I don't know. Maybe it's just me then. So I'm gonna reload the game here real quick just because I wanna see what's going on with my audio. It's weird. Maybe I need to relaunch this. Oh, I see what the problem is already. I see what the problem is. I got the Logitech gaming software, which is used for my headphones, died. So, give me a second. I gotta turn my headphones off for this to work. Oh, this is gonna screw up everything. Hold on. I know, guys. This is not ideal. You guys can't see this, but the software keeps freaking out and keeps adding, deleting my headphones. So hold on. All right, test. Okay. I hope that didn't screw anything up. Did it just reload XSplit? I think it did. Hang on, I'm gonna play some music to see if it did it. Okay, let me know if you guys can hear the music. I hope you guys can. It shows an XSplit that you guys can hear the music, but I'm not 100% certain. All right, so I'm gonna pause that. Let's go find Portal again. Sorry about this. I've never streamed Portal before, so there's always these little hiccups that happen. Okay, the music sounds fine. The music from the game, that is. Okay, where's... I can't read what it says. Where's this load? A load game, there it is. Oh, there we go, that fixed it. Oh, much better, much better. Can you be a mod? Kamiri, I hand out my mod things very...
Please place the weighted storage cube on the 1500 megawatt Aperture Science Heavy Duty Super Colliding Super Button. Perfect. Please move quickly to the chamber lock, as the effects of prolonged exposure to the button are not part of this test.
That's funny. There we go. Then we gotta wait for the exit. This thing will change eventually. There we go. Alright. So these early ones are just really basic, like, rooms and puzzles and everything, so it's nothing fancy. What is this? I don't keep thinking there's something going buggy with the game. Or my browser.
You're doing very well. Please be advised that a noticeable taste of blood is not part of any test protocol, but is an unintended side effect of the Aperture Science Material Emancipation Grip, which may, in semi-rare cases, emancipate dental fillings, crowns, tooth enamel, and teeth. Very good. You are now in possession of the Aperture Science handheld portal device. With it, you can create your own portals. These intradimensional gates have proven to be completely safe. The device, however, has not. Do not touch the operational end of the device. Do not look directly at the operational end of the device. Do not submerge the device in liquid, even partially. Most importantly, under no circumstances should you...
What is a mod? A mod is someone in my channel who can manipulate my channel. They can do things like change the title. They can ban people. They can unban people. They can mute people. They can issue commands to my Nightbot. They can create commands in my Nightbot. A mod is a very powerful person, and the only person who can do anything against mods is the streamer. And mods are used mostly as crowd control.
Please proceed to the chamber lock. Mind the gap.
Yeah, dog. So you gotta go over there and do this.
Okay. Well done. Remember, the Aperture Science Bring Your Daughter to Work Day is the perfect time to have her tested.
It's the perfect time to have her tested. I love Gladys. They wrote her so well. And in the sequel, the British guy that they have in there in place of Gladys is hysterical too.
Welcome to Test Chamber 4. You're doing quite well. Once again, excellent work. As part of our required test protocol, we will not monitor the next test chamber. You will be entirely on your own. Good luck.
There's not really any fixed criteria for how to become a mod. It's kind of left by discretion. It's got to do with whether or not, and I guess, I don't know, that's kind of an undefined answer. I would say that it's more got to do with, like, regular viewership, like interaction, like whether I feel I can trust you. I think that's the biggest thing. Whether I can trust that individual to take care of my stream. Because it's less about like, oh, we're buddies, and more about like, I'm making you a business partner because you're going to help monitor my stream and keep things from going haywire.
As part of a required test protocol, our previous statement suggesting that we would not monitor this chamber was an outright fabrication. Good job. As part of a required test protocol, we will stop enhancing the truth in 3, 2, 1.
I guess the short version of what you have to do to be a mod is, you and I have got to hang out a lot. Not necessarily in person, but it's got to do with a certain amount of interaction, certain amount of trust, certain amount of things like that. So it's like, you've got to be a regular and interactive. And
while safety is one of many Enrichment Center goals, the Aperture Science High Energy Pellet seen to the left of the chamber can and has caused unbelievable. You.
Subject name here.
Must be the pride of.
Subject hometown here.
Also, if you notice, these elevators are a lot like the elevators in Half-Life also, so I know that they use a lot of the same common things, but I mean, if you look at this, this really is Half-Life Episode 3, effectively.
Warning devices are required on all mobile equipment. However, alarms and flashing hazard lights have been found to agitate the high-energy pellet and have therefore been disabled for your safety. Good. Now use the Aperture Science unstationary scaffold to reach the chamber lock.
That it's the idea that like I said, when I make somebody a mod, I have to be able to trust that their judgment is going to be in alignment with mine in regards to trolls and people saying offensive things in my chat. That has nothing to do with like whether I trust you individually or not. It's got to do with the fact that I have to get to know you is the short version. And you know, you've been in my stream, you know, regularly for the
last. Please know that we have added
streams,
a consequence for failure. Any contact with the chamber floor will result in an unsatisfactory mark on your official testing record, followed by death. Good luck.
Followed by death. That's gonna pretty much whack me, isn't it? Yeah, it is. So I need to do this differently. How do I... Something goes there. Is that there, and then... Where's the mark? Okay. So that second line. It goes through there. how to do this one. How does that go? Goes something like, is it like this? Oh, I know how to do it. Hold on, it's this. And then it bounces back. Okay, that's how you do it. There you go. Trick is now I gotta walk over. And you do something like this that then allows you to walk back. So yeah, this is how we get out of here.
Very impressive. Please note that any appearance of danger is merely a device to enhance your testing experience. The Enrichment Center regrets to inform you that this next test is impossible. Make no attempt to solve it.
I remember how to do this, just can't remember how to do this.
The Enrichment Center apologizes for this clearly broken test chamber.
Oh, I'm an idiot. There you go. Yeah, hang on. This is not as dumb as you look.
Once again, the Enrichment Center offers its most sincere apologies on the occasion of this unsolved fantastic. You remain resolute and resourceful in an atmosphere of extreme pessimism.
In extreme pessimism, GLaDOS, you are the best voice actress ever.
Hello again. To reiterate, previous warning. For the momentum.
I gotta do this.
Spectacular. You appear to understand how a portal affects forward momentum, or to be more precise, how it does not. Momentum, a function of mass and velocity, is conserved between portals. In layman's terms, speedy thing goes in, speedy thing comes out.
Speedy thing comes in, speedy thing comes out. It's my birthday, I turned 14. Yay, congratulations, woohoo! What does that icon actually type? I don't know what that icon is you typed. I think it's supposed to be like a person's face. I'm not sure what that icon is, but congratulations on your birthday. Happy birthday, man.
The Enrichment Center promises to always provide a safe testing environment. In dangerous testing environments, the Enrichment Center promises to always provide useful advice. For instance, the floor here will kill you. Try to avoid it.
True. Alright. Not what I want to do. I need to do... Oh, I know what I gotta do. Okay, I gotta wait for that thing to turn this way. And then now I can walk up into this room here. Somehow get okay. Now I gotta go look at the room and see where I gotta put this thing. So it needs to be on that wall there. This is where it needs to be. Plus, okay. Well, happy birthday, as I said.
The device has been modified so that it can now manufacture two linked portals at once. As part of an optional test protocol, we are pleased to present an amusing fact. The device is now more valuable than the organs and combined incomes of everyone in.
Subject Hong Kong, here. Yeah.
Shit. I'm a derp. That's what I am. I'm a derp. So I'll leave one portal open there and then I just gotta open the other one over here. Alright, and we're out of here.
Get your feet there, fling yourself. Meddling into space.
I did that wrong. Hold on, I gotta go like this. There we go. Oh, I gotta to take my Gatorade out of the freezer. I totally put my Gatorade in the freezer. Oh, shit. So if you guys haven't played Portal before, this game is very funny. It just starts off boring like this. It's funny as hell later. But it's got to have a slow burn to make you feel comfortable, right?
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time. If you become lightheaded from dirt, feel free to pass out. An intubation associate will be dispatched to revive you with peptic salve and adrenaline.
Alright, so what I gotta do is this. And then, I don't know where the other portal goes. Oh, the other portal's gonna go. Easy peasy. I'm gonna go get the Gatorade. What's up, Skywise? Good morning, how are you? Welcome to the Down Tempo Sessions, where DJ tries to act chill, which we all know is a challenge. Oh shit, I didn't want to do that. Okay, so this is going to be a real challenge. Yeah, okay, here we go. That is just dizzy, let me tell you guys. Up there, so I'll put the red one here. So that's one, so how the hell do I get another one? I know it seems like very cheap and it's like puzzle-like, but the story in it is actually keeps going. You get the bits of the story through GLaDOS, who's the little helper bot that's in this game. Alright, why is this? So I guarantee you I'm gonna jump off this and it's not gonna work, right? Okay, so I only have one block. What the fuck? Okay, so that opens the door, but where's the second block? I'm really missing something here. I am, there's another room there. Okay, I'm an idiot. Okay. Yeah, there's gotta be another block. Yeah, okay. This is how it works. So where's the other portal? So now I gotta do this. So then I do... This is how I do it. There. That's how I get the door open. Now then, I need to go like this. Like this, and then fall down. Oop, not quite the right... Look, what did I have? I need to get the right place. There we go.
As part of a previously mentioned required test protocol, we can no longer lie to you. When the testing is over, you will be missed.
You will be missed. Yeah, GLaDOS' writing was awesome. By the way, don't think that I'm spoiling like the puzzles and stuff for you guys. To be honest, if you play the game, you'll actually struggle with it anyway, just like every other human. Why is my mouse being weird? There we go. Actually, options, mouse sensitivity, on raw input. We're gonna increase it slightly here, we'll do that. Okay, that feels good, that feels good. I like how they tell you sort of what you need to do in each one of these. And by the way, we're at 14 of 19, by the way, so let's see here. Looks like I can be hit in the head with falling blocks, balls, things I gotta electrocute. I can die in the water, I gotta jump to fly, and then I'm not allowed to use the drinking fountain.
All subjects intending to handle high-energy gamma-leaking portal technology must be informed that they may be informed of applicable regulatory compliance issues. No further compliance information is required or will be provided, and you are an excellent test subject.
Okay, how the shit do we get the block? No, the portals don't work on these walls. Okay. Oh, I know how to get there. Okay, so I've got a little portal there, and then jump. There we go. Oh, that, you can take damage in this, and you can die. It's just highly unlikely. Out, but that's not the exit. So that is activated by me lighting this blue strip up here, which means I need to activate this thing. So there's gonna have to be a portal here because there's a ball that's gonna have to come through here, I'm guessing. So, and the portal orientation is important. There we go. So, okay, let's go back to the store over here. Now, the second portal has more dialogue and is a bit more interactive than the first portal, but the first portal is very good considering this game came out around the time that Half-Life 2 did. Well, that's not fun. Oh, they do come back up, though. Okay, good.
Very good. A complimentary victory lift has been activated in the main chamber.
Yep, we should be right here. So when I first played this game, I'm like, oh, this is really simple. It's like no big deal. It's like I'm already on what, test chamber 15 of 19. I'm almost done with the game. No wonder this game is considered so short.
The Enrichment Center is committed to the well-being of all participants. Cake and brief counseling will be available at the conclusion of the test. Thank you for helping us help you help us all.
Okay, so what the fuck? There's gotta be... Oh, I see what I gotta do. This is gonna be a pain in the ass. I don't know, I gotta do this. Sorry. This is one of these things where you gotta accelerate yourself. So I gotta, like, I'm gonna drop down here, and then I'm gonna fall right here, and then I have to. This is the. See, Portal 2 isn't like this. See, Portal 1 requires fast reactions. This one doesn't. There. See? So Portal 1 requires fast reactions when you've got. You'll have to, like, do things like bam, bam! Like, super fast, and, like, switch your portals, right? Later on in the game. Portal 2, you don't have to do it, because they realize that this is a puzzle game, not a fast-twitch shooter. That's the exit, okay. How do I... It erases my portals. So how do I... Okay, so... No, okay, so watch. I'm gonna do this and this. So I watch it shoot through. I did this wrong. Hold on. There, now it comes through. Ah, now it bounces, and now I can go. See? There you go. Just right, so my orientation's correct, and now I've got a... Oh, what the hell? How the hell do I actually do this? I can't put a portal down here. Yeek. Yeah, see, it shows you where you gotta jump through it and then shoot another portal. Fucking thing is, how the hell do you do that when you don't have the distance to start with? Oh, never mind. I'm an idiot. You go up here somewhere, I assume. Yeah, buddy! Alright, so that's how this is gonna work. So I gotta do. Oh. Damn it. I botched that. Here we go. Here we go. So you gotta jump through and then shoot another portal. Ah, foo. See, this is what I'm talking about where it's like, it's all fast twitch. You gotta do it, you gotta time it just right. Which is something I think the game designers realized was a terrible idea. Right. When they did the second game, that is. Oh, I missed it. You gotta jump through the hole, is what you have to do. And then it'll have an accelerative force to shoot you through the hole. I guess I gotta... No, hold on. I gotta shoot it, like, basically right underneath me, and I'm not doing this correctly. I know what I need to do, I just am sucking at it. So, I need the portal to aim... Let's see here. Looks like right about... There looks good. Maybe... There? Just like when I skid through it? Alright, so that's what I gotta look for when I jump through. I missed it. I hit... Aw, man. See, this is just gonna take practice just to get used to this part. This is where... This is, like, where you can speedrun this game in a minute. You know? There. Got over it. Yay! Okay. Now, for this, it's gotta land in this thing, but how do I get it to bounce the portal back? I don't even know how to get over there. Alright, so how the fuck... How in the hell? That got me over here. Clearly, I have to throw myself over there. Oh, I don't. This. Okay, so this doesn't activate till I power that. Oh, Jesus, I know what I gotta do. This is that stupid thing where I gotta launch myself over it again. Alright. Let's see where I fall. There we go. Okay. So now how do I angle this back? So I gotta go... Dink, dink. Okay, so I need a portal to be... There. And here. That's what I have to do. No, that's not what I wanted to do. Goes in there. What the hell? Wait a minute, hold on, whoa, whoa, whoa. That's not right. Oh, because it comes in at an angle. No, that didn't do it either. So maybe there. No, definitely not that either. So it's gotta be there. Yep, that was it. Okay, now how the hell do I get out of here? do I get out of here? There is a way out of this room. Just don't know where. Is there a ceiling hole or something? Okay, so now I need to get back on the other side of this barrier, but I have no way to launch myself over there. Yes, I do. Okay. This is gonna be fucking fun. There we go. Alright. Battery is fully charged! Yay! That's gonna slide underneath there. I don't want that. Oh shit. Okay, I know how to do this. I see how this works. You gotta work backwards to get the platforms. And then go like this. Ah! Don't land on the shit! Okay, the orientation on that was a little disorienting, but okay, I'm in this room now. Where's the thing that's gotta be activated? I'm guessing. There's a button I have to push someplace. No, it's over there. How the fuck do we get up there? I think this is the one room my girlfriend couldn't get past, but she can figure out how to do it. So you do it. The hell, the door doesn't open? Oh, I see what you gotta do. I'm an idiot. So there's two blast doors you gotta do, and you gotta... Okay. So, first thing first. You gotta go like this. Then you gotta go.
Did you know you can donate one or all of your vital organs to the Aperture Science Self-Esteem Fund for Girls? It's true.
One or all of your organs to the Self-Esteem Fund. Yeah, my girlfriend couldn't get past this room here. Because I don't think she realized that there was two blast doors here. I think she only saw that there was one. She's been on stream once. She doesn't like being on stream though. She's been here maybe a while ago, right at the end of the stream. You saw her walk past. She's never showed her face, but she is, if you run into her in chat, her name, she goes by the name Hotaru Hana.
Due to mandatory scheduled maintenance, the appropriate chamber for this testing sequence is currently unavailable. It has been replaced with a live fire course designed for military androids. The Enrichment Center apologizes for the inconvenience and wishes you the best of luck.
Yeah.
Please put me down.
I did this wrong, and I know why, because I need to drive the block. I forgot the blocks were here. Actually. It says help. What you do is you do this.
I get lost.
It stayed upright, whatever. C to crouch. I get that. Yay, C to crouch. There's a bucket. There's a frying pan. On a Aperture computer. This little side area here. The cake is a lie. The cake is a lie. Help. Can I help you? I don't know what this is. It's cray cray, is what it is.
Hello, sir.
Oh shit, damn it! I thought I dropped the thing on it perfectly. I guess you gotta drop it in front of it. Alright, whatever. Fuck that up pretty good.
Good night. Activated. There you are. Searching. Who's there? Who are you?
Who are you?
Malfunction.
Oh, Jesus Christ, I had a point right at me.
Well done, Android. The Enrichment Center once again reminds you that Android Hell is a real place where you will be sent at the first sign of defiance.
Android Hell? the first sign of defiance, not the second, not the fifth, but only the first.
The vital apparatus vent will deliver a weighted companion cube in 3, 2, 1. This weighted companion cube will accompany you through the test chamber. Please take care of it. The symptoms most commonly produced by Enrichment Center testing are superstition, perceiving inanimate objects as alive, and hallucinations. The Enrichment Center reminds you that the weighted companion cube will never threaten to stab you and, in fact, cannot speak.
Oh, I need to go this way. That's okay. So there's two of these things. Companion cube. See, it's got a little heart on it. That's what it means. Companion cube. See how all the other cubes didn't have like cute little hearts on them? This has a heart on it. That's why. Okay. No, wait a minute. That's not right. I need to do it there. There, now it'll go in the way it's supposed to. Going to these little hidey holes where he's clearly destroyed all the cameras, a bunch of cameras. It shows all his notes, and he's like, "Not never bat now." I don't know. Not never. I don't know what that means, but whatever. And it's basically saying, "Look, all these people, all these pictures and everything." And these pictures actually get brought up in Portal 2. She's watching you. Beep.
To ensure the safe performance of all authorized activities, do not destroy vital testing apparatus.
Okay. I like how there's like a door here that doesn't do anything. It's just like, oh, here's a door. Oh, I see what you gotta do. Yeah. Okay, this makes sense. Find somebody to put this on there. Alright, so now how the fuck? Alright, so I gotta go. So this has to come in here like this. Okay, so this portal has to be here. So this guy should shoot one here, right? Why isn't it shooting one? Why isn't this one shooting? Oh, this one's energy has been used up. That's why. Okay, that makes a lot more sense now. Whoa! Oh, that's gonna shoot it right towards my face, isn't it? Yes, it is. Dodge. I need it to bounce, but then I need it to bounce this way. Whoa! Oh shit, that's not supposed to, damn it. This is a little trickier, because I gotta get it all the way to the back here. Alright. Jesus, I'm an idiot. Where's the fucking the cube I need? Alright, so this will permanently mount that one. I'm an idiot. Oh, fuck, I died. Damn it, I know what I gotta do. I gotta use this thing to deflect it. I just stuck it in the wrong place, is what I did.
The Enrichment Center reminds you that the Weighted Companion Cube cannot speak. In the event that the Weighted Companion Cube does speak, the Enrichment Center urges you to disregard its advice.
Disregard its advice. Okay, so this thing has to be... Well, how's it here if it gets deflected? Okay, so I need... two cubes to hold this thing open. So this one activates and then it opens the door to get out of here. So the question becomes, how, well, hold on. Oh, I missed, damn it. What the hell? Oh, I'm holding it in the wrong place. Someplace else. So now I've got one where a ball can come out, but where can I put it so it exits properly? I'm guessing here. So we can go through here because this is the only way out, so it's got to be here. That's not what I gotta do. What I gotta do is I gotta... Maybe I can angle it around? I guess? I just can try to maybe bank shot it? Here it comes. I'm gonna try to angle it. I don't know, ricochet it the right way it needs to go. Maybe angle it this way. Can't hear it, there it is. Nope, shot it back the way it came. Alright, so I'm gonna try something different then here. Where's it at? Come on. Oh, I missed it. Gotta have two buttons here. There's gotta be something I'm missing here. Oh, fuck! I stepped right in front of it.
Weighted Companion Cube cannot speak. In the event that the Weighted Companion Cube does speak, the Enrichment Center urges you to disregard its advice.
Disregard something. Alright, let's go. Thank you. Yeah, I think that's what I have to do. Because that's literally what my next attempt was. Ah! Damn it, it shot me in the back!
Companion cube cannot speak. In the event that the weighted companion cube does speak, the Enrichment Center urges you to disregard its advice.
And yes, you're right, that's exactly how you have to do it. The problem is that I have to stand in the way to do it. It's a timing issue. Whoa! So it's a timing issue where you have to get out of the way right at that exact instant. And that's what they fixed in Portal 2, is that you don't need to do the fast twitch stuff. So. But yes, that's exactly what you have to do. Now. I'm gonna defend myself with this for the moment. But the ball doesn't last perpetually. You know what? I guess I can just leave that there. And just do this. I'm a dumbass. I don't know why I made that complicated. Oh, shit. Gotta wait for a new one to come through. Here's a new one. Yeah. Should open the last one. There. And what the? Okay, now my controls are moving. For some reason, my guy stopped being able to move. Or my girl, because it is a girl. Oh, I gotta go get the cube again. Forgot. Derp. Ignore the fact that I went full derp. I wish you could sprint as much as you can't. I don't think you can. Yeah, you can't sprint in this. You can sprint in the second game.
You did it. The weighted companion cube certainly brought you good luck. However, it cannot accompany you for the rest of the test and, unfortunately, must be euthanized. Please escort your companion cube to the Aperture Science Emergency Intelligence Incinerator. You euthanized your faithful companion cube more quickly than any test subject on record. Congratulations.
Yay, I'm euthanizing. Yay, euthanizing. Woo, for assisted suicide.
The experiment is nearing its conclusion.
What's up, Sago?
The Enrichment Center is required to remind you that you will be baked, and then there will be cake.
You will be baked, and then there will be cake, huh? By the way, I still love how you're not allowed to ever drink water. You can do all this other shit, but you're not allowed to drink water. No fucking water for you. I think you can still get out of here. No, that's the way I came. Now you can do... that, or you can explore here. So they make you care about a cube and they make you kill it. Sort of. Welcome to GLaDOS. Fucking whack job is what she is. She just said, you will bake. Thank you. I like how the radio is still playing even though it's underwater down there. Never bought now. Courage is not absence of fear. Okay, buddy, whatever. I need to do actually this in order to get over there. Shit. Oh, that's how. Okay. Oh, it doesn't let you do that? The fuck? Okay, whatever. Now. Is there a floor? No, there isn't. But there's a wall. Alright. How the hell am I gonna do this? I'm not. I'm gonna do this first. Okay. Now there's the exit, which means. Okay, this is how this is gonna happen. Exit, but that means I gotta get the cube from the other room, right? Okay. Oh no, don't crush me. Shit! Forgot about that. Alright. Okay, so this room requires me to blow shit up, so where's the ball explode from? Okay, so that goes there. Oh, the game froze! No, it didn't. Started. Frack. Okay. Just do that, that'll knock it over. I'm gonna save it before this thing completely goes nuts. So save. Yeah. Okay. Now, I've gotta activate that door, but I gotta get this thing lowered. So, I gotta do this. This looks like a tricky situation. Okay. Open. Okay. Okay. So you gotta hit this button. Alright. That should lower this platform, right? I think. So. this is what I gotta do. I gotta wait for that thing to aim through it and shoot. Okay, then I gotta go. Got it. That now powers that platform. Okay. Okay, so now that also stops the thing from shooting. Very nice. Now where the fuck do I go? Down there probably, right? Yeah, that seems logical. Because, you know, it's right there and all. Ah! Don't go that way. Okay. Okay, so that angles up. Which does what for me? Oh, I must have to, like, launch myself across the room. Is there a platform down here I need to go to? Okay, so I gotta find what platform I gotta launch myself across. And then do that. Yeah. Okay, so... myself off of one of those. Right, there's another power. Is this it? Okay. So, I've killed all the guns. Now we gotta ricochet my way across, but I don't see how I'm supposed to do that. Even if I open a portal here, where the hell does it launch me off to? Hold on. I think maybe I gotta hit the floor. Can I? I don't know. Yeah, I can. Okay. That's what I gotta do. I gotta somehow launch myself off of that. Right? Why does that seem right, though? That seems like it's too far away for me to do that. I've beaten this game, but I've only played through it once. This is only my second playthrough. Huh. Killed all the bots, activated the lift. It's gotta be something where, like, I... Yeah, and these platforms here were just used just to hold the little turrets. Is there something down... Oh! I figured it out right there. Okay. So... Okay. That's where I'm supposed to drop through. That makes sense. So I'm an idiot. So what I do is I put the portal there, have the other end there, and then fire myself out like a cannon. So I come out here, leave the portal there, but then put the other end of it right here. So... There. Okay, I was looking for where the high drop was. I didn't see it. So yeah, I gotta drop down there. Right there, that's where I gotta fall. So right where that hole is, that's where I'm gonna fall. Actually, above it is probably where I'll fall. Okay. Gotta hurry, and I know what I gotta do now. I gotta go in here. Yeah, watch. So then this is how I do it. So I don't have to do all the jumping across the map. So then I activate it from here, and I have more time. Yeah, okay, see, now I got more time. So then I do this. that, and now I just fall in. It should be... There we go. Okay. What do I do with this thing? Okay, so I got up here. Now what? Fuck is the exit? Alright, I'm gonna grab the cube and just... I don't know what I do with this cube, but... I have a cube now. Oh, that's right. I gotta go in here. Durr. That's right. This whole thing was just to get the cube. This doesn't matter where I'm at. And then... There. Oh, I fucking hate this one. Oh, this makes me fucking sick to my stomach. I forgot about this one. Oh, yeah, this is gonna make me vomit. Yeah. Yeah, this is gonna make me sick. Yeah, I did some. Oh, I see what I did wrong. Yeah. No. Ugh, fuck. Damn it! Fucking rotating me around. Okay. This is gonna make me very sick. So what you gotta do is you gotta. Oh, yeah. This is not gonna work. Okay, so. Okay, here we go. So just put this down here. I know how this is gonna work, but I think I can't angle it the way I want to here, right? No. Okay. Alright, here's how you do this. Well, not like that, obviously, because I missed my fucking target. Okay. Well, kind of fucked. All right, whatever. I can do. Can I aim? I can't quite see that angle, though, can I? Ugh, fuck, I guess I'm really good. This is gonna make someone dizzy. Not me. It just maybe slightly dizzy. Okay. All right. So I cannot mess this up. If I can get up high enough, though, I think I can ricochet myself off of that thing, which is the goal, that little doohickey right there. So let's just put that there. Realign this. All right, here we go.
Well done. Be advised that the next test requires exposure to uninsulated electrical parts that may be dangerous under certain conditions. For more information, please attend an Enrichment Center Electrical Safety Seminar.
That nearly made me sick. In fact, I think my girlfriend made it past another room, and I think she got to this one, and it's like, I can't do this, I'm getting motion sick. I don't feel bad, so did I the first time I did it. Like, I actually had to get... I was considering taking a Dramamine because the first time I did that, I didn't know how to do it, so I was like spinning around like endlessly.
Welcome to the final test.
Cake!
When you are done, you will drop the device in the Equipment Recovery Annex. Enrichment Center regulations require both hands to be empty before any cake...
Oh, shit.
Okay. this in order to... Oh shit!
For your own safety, do not destroy vital testing apparatus. Kill me? Oh shit. Okay. Didn't know you could die by being crushed by the door. Alright, that's new. Is now over. All aperture technologies remain safely operational up to 4,000 degrees Kelvin. Rest assured that there is absolutely no chance of a dangerous equipment malfunction prior to your victory and essence. Thank you for participating in this aperture science computer-aided enrichment activity. Goodbye.
Get out of here, but I gotta be careful about how I... No, I can't. It's like this.
What are you doing? Stop it. We are pleased that you made it through the final challenge where we pretended we were going to murder you. We are very, very happy for your success. We are throwing a party in honor of your tremendous success. Place the device on the ground, then lie on your stomach with your arms at your sides. A party associate will arrive shortly to collect you for your party. Make no further attempt to leave the testing area. Assume the party escort submission position or you will miss the party.
Door. There is a way out of here. I just don't remember where the hell it is. Oh, I'm an idiot. You gotta... Oh, shit. I think what it is, you gotta... This is where you link the portal back to someplace else? Oh, I'm not dead, but how the fuck do I... Yeah, this is where I screwed this up. think I'm stuck here. I know you can get out of here somehow. I've done it. I just don't remember where. Maybe... certainly isn't... you know what? Maybe... That hurts apparently, so we're not gonna do that. We're gonna try to maybe aim that a little higher. There. Maybe so near the water. Maybe I need this portal to actually. Can I shoot through the portals? Okay, I can. Oh shit! Not what I was hoping for. It did do what I wanted to do, but it pushed me on the other side.
What are you doing? Stop it. Shit. We are pleased that you made it through the final challenge where we pretended we were going to murder you. We are very, very happy for your success.
Alright.
We are throwing a party in honor of your
tremendous
success.
There's a way out of here, I just forgot
how to do it. Place the device on the ground. What are you doing?
Okay.
Stop it.
That's not what I wanted to do.
We are very, very happy for your success. We are throwing a party in honor of your tremendous success.
Cat, what are you doing?
Place the device on the ground, then lie on your stomach with your arms at your sides.
Oh, I know how to get out of here.
The party associate will arrive shortly to collect you for your party.
I'm an idiot. Okay, so...
make no further attempt to leave the testing area. Assume the party escort submission position or you will miss the party.
This is how you do it. You launch yourself this way. This is how you get out. There we go. I don't know why that was so difficult. Chart here that says Black Mesa and Aperture, and it says 5-year review GSA schedules proposed, and it says awarded. Defense logistics bids: Black Mesa costly, Mesa personnel overpaid given limited skill set ambition, design inhibits nothing more. Less expensive bonus, blah blah blah. So basically, this is episode 3, but no one wants to admit it. This is Half-Life episode 3. If you go up to a wall, you can sort of press it against it. Okay, so. Alright. Wait a minute, didn't I just jump? Oh, I just walked through this room. Okay, whatever. Oh, I didn't want to do that. I forgot. It's not my run button. It's the other portal button. I need to go this way anyway.
The test is over now. You win. Go back to the recovery annex for your cake. It was a fun test, and we're all impressed at how much you won. The test is over. Come back.
I need a cube to get through. How do you do this without the cube? I held on to the cube. Where the fuck did it go, though? Okay. Can't pick any of those up. How the fuck do I get through here? Way. There we go. Okay. Loading. I'm loading. I'm saving is what I really am. Nope. Alright.
You're not even going the right way. Where do you think you're going? Because I don't think you're going where you think you're going. Hello? Started? No. I'm in a different section here. Okay. Okay. I don't know where I gotta go. Oh, I gotta go up there. Oh, I'm an idiot. Okay, okay, okay. I need to go there. I gotta do a lot of jumping. More than likely. Okay. Myself across the room? How do I do that? Can they smoke a bottle? No, they can't. Alright. I gotta get up there. But the ladder doesn't work. Alright. So how do I launch myself across the room to that section there? Get over there. I just need to be able to see what's over there. Right? That's all I really need. So it's behind me. So that's what's there. Alright, so that's all I need. I couldn't figure out my orientation, that's what this does. Didn't we have some fun, though? Remember when the platform was sliding into the fire pit and I said goodbye, and you were like,
no word.
And then I was all, we pretended we were going to murder you.
That was great. Is anyone there?
Alright. So I gotta get over there. I'm just gonna launch myself. So that means I'm gonna do this.
Damn it, I got flattened.
You really shouldn't be here. This isn't safe for you. It's not too late for you to turn back. I'm not angry. Just go back to the dressing room.
There's the exit to this place. Can't see the exit up there. Oh, there it is.
too. How the fuck do I get up there? Upstairs to go to nowhere. I don't think that's the solution. Maybe I do have to land above this thing somehow, this tube. No, it needs the tube. This thing needs to be moved over. So now where can I portal myself to? Oh. Just jump? Oh, I guess I can just jump. I made that way more complicated than I needed to, I guess. Okay, there's the exit. No? It says go down here? What?
Hey!
Oh, that's what it is. Okay.
Yes.
So hold on. I know how to fix this. You gotta blow the tube up. You gotta do it. You gotta do it up higher, right? Yeah. So it blows the tube up, and then you can use the cube to get in there or some shit. That's how this works. DJ, what's up? What's up, Mickey B. Bread? There it is. That's what I wanted. I need to blow it up right when a cube is going by. How you doing? I'm going to be streaming for about, well, only about 45 more minutes because I've got a brunch I have to go to. So I'm going to hope to complete this game in 45 minutes. I don't think I am, though, because I know I'm not close to finishing it. Out of here. Yeah, but hey, but thanks for coming. I mean, hey, I'm gonna be here. The only reason because it's let's see, it's 10:45 now. At 11:30, I gotta get showered. I'll be back streaming again this evening though, so this is gonna be a dual stream day for me. I'm just not sure how I'm gonna get this thing to. How the hell do I get this thing to blow up? How I get down in there. Fuck. Do I have to take this thing with me? Will it fit? Yeah, so how are you doing this morning? I don't even know if what I'm doing is right. I probably don't think I'm doing this right. Probably fucking this up. I know I gotta go down there, but I don't remember how to go down there. I better not. Hold on. If I don't take this with me, I'll never be able to get back into this area again. You know, I'm all right. I had a very, very calm weekend. I went to, I went to go visit my parents yesterday for their birthdays. Their birthdays are, what the hell? Are, sort of close together. But then my, maybe that's what I gotta do. Maybe that's how I get up. Oh, shoot, I'm an idiot. That's how I do this. I get pulled up into this grate, right? That's how this works. How I do this? So that one's broken. That's how I get out, right? Somewhere here? Okay, I'm not sure now. So I went to go visit, then I came home and watched the Blackhawks win. We were behind 3-1 against the St. Louis Blues, and we beat them 6-3. We fucking annihilated them. Brunch is just an excuse for people to have breakfast in the PM hours. Alright, so there's gotta be more than one way to do this. Could it be that there's a portal I can put here? What is it? That's the orange ones I need. I'll stick puck. Yeah. You know what? The thing is. You know, Chicago, I've always been into hockey because, my dad's been into hockey for a lot of years, and so because of that, I just kind of am just by default. So where the fuck do I put this other portal? There's got to be a way, a place for me to put this thing where I can blow some more shit up. But where the fuck is it? This puzzle isn't completed yet. I know it's not, but where the hell do I put the other part of it? I don't know. There. No idea where I put this other portal. Yeah, you know, I know. A lot of gamers just don't get into real sports. I mean, I played soccer for a while, but I hate watching soccer. I love playing it, but I cannot stand watching it. It's so boring.
Hockey, on the other hand, I can watch, but I have no chance of ever playing. Like, I just don't have, I just can't skate that well. So. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know where this is supposed to go. What it's supposed to do. I'm missing something here, guys, and I don't know what it is. I don't know. I thought I blew that thing up already. I love football, but for some reason... Okay, I got it. Okay, so I don't get this. I found the fucking cube. It wants me to go in here. I see the bloody handprints. It tells me to go this way. Then what the fuck do I do once I'm in here? I can't go anywhere. I can't get past the fan blade. How do I destroy the fan blade? No, there's nothing up there. That's the thing. There's nothing at the top. You can portal the top and the missile breaks the fan. Yeah, but there's nothing at the top. There's nothing there to portal to. That's what I thought too. I assumed that you gotta use the missile to break the fan, but I can't. There's no surface to portal onto here. I mean, you can clearly see there's nothing above me. Maybe there's is the game bugged? Hold on. I'll do a different one. Let's load the game. Actually, let's exit the game, because the game didn't crash twice. Or it stuttered. It froze up, and I think I know why, too. Hang on. Give me a second, guys. Why is this not working? Alright. We're going to relaunch the game. I think I can beat it in 35 minutes. No idea how to get past this. There's a bug. I know I'm supposed to use the missiles. Wait a minute. Hold on. I got it. Hold on. That's where I'm supposed to do it. It's not up. It's down. Got it. Solved it. Although, that does give me an idea. Because that's not how I get down here. I'm an idiot. That's how you get down here. I don't need to blow it. Whoa! I don't want to fall off here. Yeah, I knew I was missing something there. I'm like, this can't be this hard. I'm not gliding down here. What is this goop? The hell? Oh, shit. Alright, that's okay, so now I gotta remember. Alright. I know what I'm doing. Let's see, dude.
and get a lay of the land. So my trick now should be to kill some of these things off. Which means do this.
There you are.
Pepper, nice. Now I got time to be doing what you're doing. Pepper, get the fuck down!
Uh-oh.
So if you pre-ordered Overwatch, does that mean you now have the beta? Because I know you do. I know that that's, I think, what they're trying to do.
Please put me down. Who are you?
You get 2 days earlier access to the open beta, so instead of May 5th, it's May 3rd. Oh, okay, I see what you're getting at, yo. Yo, yo, yo! Yo, 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 yo. I didn't want to do that, I wanted to do that. So Paragon, by the way, is open for, they want to charge $1 billion for that, which I think is $1 billion silly. I don't have this set up the way I wanted to. I need, where's the bounce pad? There we go. Alright, actually what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do this. I'm an idiot, so... Shit, I know what I gotta do there. Gotta put portals underneath them so they keep falling. I didn't react fast enough. But never seen it. So Paragon is, imagine you mixed Overwatch and League of Legends. So it's a third-person MOBA, is what it is. And what's funny is that Paragon, and actually let me start this over. League of Legends would not have existed at all without the original Dota. The original Dota was actually mimicked after the Onslaught mode of Unreal 2003. Because Onslaught mode, you had two bases that were shielded, you couldn't kill them. Unless you create a path of nodes to that base, and that would drop the shields. And then all, and that was it. So you, the nodes would be in weird patterns. Yeah, there is one called Smite, but what I'm getting at is that Smite is all medieval and you play as, like, Greek and Roman gods.
Whereas Paragon, you just play as, like, people from Overwatch, but in a MOBA setting. And all of this shit all stems from Unreal Tournament 2003 and 2004, when the Onslaught mode was there. So really, modern gaming goes, all of League of Legends owes their shit to Unreal Tournament. Onslaught mode was great, and it was super addictive, and it was the most popular mode in that game. Alright, so here's how I'm gonna get up in there. This is how this is gonna work. I'm gonna jump down and land. The hell just happened? Oh, I see what happened. Oh. Alright. Yeah, I like that one of my favorite games of all time, which was Unreal Tournament, actually became the basis for, like, all modern gaming. What? Oh my god, I wasted all that time! I can't put a... You fucking son of a bitch! Ah, now I gotta do this shit all over again. Trying to get a six-man team together for open beta. I don't know if you're going to be able to do that. It's going to be tough to do, I think. So I think I can launch myself if I do this correctly. Oh, I didn't do it right. Damn it. Shit. Black Knight, Koshki, maybe Vampy or myself. For Paragon? Or no, I'm sorry, not Paragon. You're talking about for Overwatch, right? I probably will buy Paragon just because, I mean, I like the idea of Team Deathmatch. You know, and it doesn't, like I said, to be honest, like, Paragon, I'm sorry, not Paragon. For Overwatch is effectively, what is it? Team Fortress, which is nothing more than Team Deathmatch, right? Yeah, Overwatch. Sorry, I don't know why I said Paragon. What I'm saying is that Overwatch is Team Fortress, which is nothing more than Team Deathmatch, which is crazy because it's like Blizzard's making a first-person shooter. Oh my god! All right, so how the hell am I gonna do this? Try to do it here. What happened? Oh, I angled out of it. That's what I did. You know, Overwatch, they have all sorts of game modes. There we go. Made it out. Now what? Oh, this is easy. Okay. Oh, why did it jump? No, you dumb fuck. There. In the right place, yeah. Also, from playing it, I can say I had way more fun in Overwatch than I ever had in Team Fortress 2. Yeah, but you gotta remember, Team Fortress 2 is how old? It's an old game. Dollars and cents competing with Black Mesa, or. What is Black Mesa? 3% of all DoD contracts, 10 billion in federal funds annually, 12% from no bids, exclusive source, not bound by government performance results and actions. And then it says 5-year. Yeah. Basically, this is. By the way, if you guys don't know, I have a theory that I believe is accurate, and I believe that Portal is actually Half-Life Episode 3. Oh, I am going to be able to beat the game.
Well, you found me. Congratulations. Was it worth it? Because despite your violent behavior, the only thing you've managed to break so far is my heart. Maybe you could settle for that and we'll just call it a day. I guess we both know that isn't going to happen. You chose this path. Now I have a surprise for you. Deploying surprise in 5, 4. Time out for a second. That wasn't supposed to happen. Do you see that thing that fell out of me? What is that? It's not the surprise. I've never seen it before. Never mind. It's a mystery I'll solve later.
By myself.
Because you'll be dead. Where are you taking that thing? I wouldn't bother with that thing. My guess is that touching it will just make your life even worse, somehow. You're kidding me. Did you just stuff that aperture science thing, we don't know what it does, into an aperture science emergency intelligence incinerator? That has got to be the dumbest thing that-
Whoa.
Good news. I figured out what that thing you just incinerated did. It was a morality core they installed after I flooded the enrichment center with a deadly neurotoxin to make me stop flooding the enrichment center with a deadly neurotoxin. So get comfortable while I warm up the neurotoxin emitters. Huh. That core may have had some ancillary responsibilities. I can't shut off the turret defenses. Oh well. If you want my advice, you should just lie down in front of a rocket. Trust me. It'll be a lot less painful than the neurotoxin. All right. Keep doing whatever it is you think you're doing. Killing you and giving you good advice aren't mutually exclusive. The rocket really is the way to go. That thing you burned up isn't important to me. It's the fluid catalytic cracking unit. It made shoes for orphans. Nice job breaking it, hero.
No, I'm doing this wrong. Where the fuck is the targeting laser?
This isn't brave. It's murder. What did I ever do to you? The difference between us is that I can feel pain. You don't even care, do you?
Okay, so it's going there, so I need to move it to the right. Damn it! I know what I gotta do, I just can't do it. Fuck!
Did you hear me? I said you don't care. Are you listening? That's it. I'm done reasoning with you. Starting now, there's going to be a lot less conversation and a lot more killing.
Oh, where's the turret? What the hell? It went up there? Oh my god.
What was that? Did you say something? I sincerely hope you weren't expecting a response, because I'm not talking to you. The talking is over.
Your legs. There we go. Are you coming back? Do you smell something burning? What's that noise?
Oh, you think you're doing some damage?
2+2 is...
In base 4, I'm fine. I let you survive this long because I was curious about your behavior. Well, you've managed to destroy that part of me. Unfortunately, as much as I'd love to now, I can't get the neurotoxin into your head any faster. I'd just like to point out that you were given every opportunity to succeed. There was even going to be a party for you. A big party that all your friends were invited to. I invited your best friend, the companion cube. Of course, he couldn't come because you murdered him. All your other friends couldn't come either because you don't have any other friends. Because of how unlikable you are. It says so right here in your personnel file. Unlikable. Liked by no one. A bitter, unlikable loner whose passing shall not be more. Shall not be more. Very formal. Very official. It also says you were adopted. So that's funny, too.
Oh god, where's the fucking thing?
Speaking of curiosity, you're curious about what happens after you die, right? Guess what?
I know. You're going to find out firsthand before I finish explaining it, though, so I won't bother. Here's a hint. You're gonna want to pack as much lemon as you can into the next couple of minutes.
I love
that thing you burned up isn't important to me. It's the fluid catalytic cracking unit. It made shoes for orphans. Nice job, Slytherin. Neurotoxin. So deadly. Joking.
I'm kidding.
When I said deadly neurotoxin, the deadly was in massive sarcasm quote. I could tell that blinking into my eyes. Honestly, it's not deadly at all.
To me.
You, on the other hand, are going to find its deadliness a lot less funny. Who's gonna make the cake when I'm gone? You. Look, you're wasting your time. And believe me, you don't have a whole lot left to waste.
Damn it!
What's your point anyway? Survival. Well then, the last thing you want to do is hurt me. I have your brain scanned and permanently backed up in case something terrible happens to you. Which it's just about to. Don't believe me? Here, I'll put you on. That's you. That's how dumb you sound. You've been wrong about every single thing you've ever done, including this thing. You're not smart. You're not a scientist. You're not a doctor. You're not even a full-time employee. Where did your life go so wrong? Are you trying to escape? Things have changed since the last time you left the building.
Back in. I have an infinite capacity for knowledge.
Here we go.
And I'm not sure what's going on outside. All I know is I'm the only thing standing between us and you. And
that's swarming and I like an adult.
Got crazy.
Thank you for assuming the party escort submission position.
The party submission position. I don't remember that part of the game. The party submission position. There's the cake. And the companion cube. I don't remember this. Oh, you can't see this part. Hold on.
This was a triumph.
Sorry.
I'm making a note here. Huge success. It's hard to overstate my satisfaction.
This is great, this ending is.
Aperture science. We do what we must because we can. For the good of all of us, except the ones who are dead. But there's no sense crying over every mistake. You just keep on.
Yeah, there actually is a cake. But the cake is a lie, because they tried to kill you, remember? For the people who are still alive. Do your subject name here.
I'm not even angry. I'm being so sincere.
This is the end of the game, though, guys.
Even though
I love that part.
I'm torn into pieces, and threw every piece into a fire. As they burned, it hurt because I was so happy for you. Now these points of data make a beautiful line, and we're out of beta. We're releasing on time.
So the beta means file addendum addendum. One last
go
thing.
Ahead and leave me.
I love this ending.
I'd prefer to stay inside. Maybe you'll find someone else to help you. Maybe Black Mesa. That was a joke. Ha ha.
People who are still alive.
Believe me, I am still alive. I'm doing science and I'm still alive. I feel fantastic and I'm still alive. While you're dying, I'll be still alive.
While you're dying, I'm still alive.
And when you're dead, I will be still alive.
Final thought, P.S.
Still alive. Still alive.
Thanks for participating in this enrichment and center activity, if you notice over the left side. But that's Portal, guys. And then you get a slightly different loading screen after you beat the game. The Portal ending song is classic. But here, I want to talk. Let me move this. Let me move my camera back to. What the hell? Okay. What the fuck? Can I not grab this thing properly? Moving that, moving that. I'm gonna grab this. Okay. So anyway, I've got a theory that Portal was actually okay. So everyone wants Half-Life. Everybody wants is waiting for Half-Life Episode 3, right? Well, I got some news for you. This is Half-Life Episode 3. All right. So think about it. Now I'm gonna give spoilers away, but not like to Episode 2, just to the original Half-Life 2. So, the thing is that the way it works is that there's all this, like, black, dark energy, black hole technology and shit, right? That all started with the original Half-Life. Half-Life 2, you end up getting a gravity gun, which looks like a primitive version of the portal gun. The difference is that the gravity gun in Half-Life 2, you can shoot objects. Like, you can grab one and then hurl it fatally at an enemy, right? Well, the whole game has got, like, these aliens that are on your side in Half-Life 2 that, like, can warp space and time if they concentrate hard enough, right? So, the thing is that there's... that at the end of the original... at the end of Half-Life 2, you create a singularity, and then the game ends with you frozen in time, right? And then later on, you're plucked out of time. And then you're attacked by... Then you're recruited by the G-Man again. Well, my whole point in saying this is that the way Half-Life 2 Episode 2 ends, that the only thing that you could do that would be further was that at some point, Alex Vance gets put into this test program because she lives, right? And so the whole thing is that, like, you've got this woman named Chell, and Chell looks a lot like Alex Vance, okay? And she's also a very independent woman in that series. So while Portal was meant as, like, a side game, I seriously believe that, and I don't know why I'm not on full screen here. I seriously believe that this is episode 3, but no one realizes it. Never heard it before. Yeah, hey, what's up, Jay? Yeah, that's famous, the I'm Still Alive song. But yeah, but I seriously think that if you look at all the way Half-Life 2 episode 1 and Half-Life 2 episode 2, the way they frame all of it, Portal is episode 3, guys, because it's even more poignant when you play Portal 2 and they flesh out what happens after this little thing, because
At the end of this, I never saw the little ending with the cake and all the other crap. All right, so I never saw that. I don't remember that. I remember that something happened, and there's a quip that GLaDOS makes that if you don't kill her in time or something, she makes a quip about how that she has the ability to create a singularity, and when you destroy her, it creates a singularity and pulls everyone into the black hole, right? Well, the way Portal... And then you end up on the surface, and then it's funny, it's like the party submission position. I didn't know that that even existed. But that ending ties into what happened with Portal 2. So, like, if you played Portal 1 and Portal 2, and you remember having played at least the ending of Half-Life 2, and then you've played both episodes, they all tie together in the same storyline. Like, the technologies and models are all the same. And here's the thing, they made Portal 2 as a separate game from Half-Life 2 and Portal 1. So, but they were still using the same models, like the little cube that you see here, the companion cube, and all this other stuff. So, like, it's not like they were trying to stay with the theme of Portal. They could have changed it for the sake of Portal 2, but they didn't, which means that it's in the same universe as Half-Life. So Portal is Episode 3, and Portal 2 is like the Episode 4, I guess. That's your tinfoil hat moment, guys. But anyway, so here's the deal. So this was my down-tempo sessions. I played through Portal 1. Portal 2 is a lot longer. Like, you can speedrun Portal 1 in, like, I don't know, like, really fast. Portal 2 is a much bigger game. Like, much bigger. Like, if you know what you're doing in that game, you could beat it in 3 or 4 hours. But I played through it, and it took me, like, 8 or 10. All right, because... But I will be streaming again later today. I've got to go to a birthday brunch here in an hour. So I'm going to go ahead, and I'm going to sign off. But I'm going to quit the game. So I'm going to sign off, but I'll be back this afternoon. Probably, I'm guessing, well, let's see, it's 11:30 now or 11:20. I'm guessing I'll probably be back between 4 and 5 p.m. So about 5 or 6 hours. So, hey, Rose, you came in right at the end of the stream. Oh, yeah. What it is I got to go to a brunch, but I'll be back in like 4 or 5 hours and stream again. This is still my down-tempo session things. I'm going to go ahead and play the little outro that I normally do. Where is it? I need to find a song here that doesn't suck. Well, you know what? We'll just do... what is this? There we go. We'll play this one just because it's simple. But yes, I will be back. Like I said, 4 or 5 hours. So if you guys are in a different time zone right now, it's 20 after 11. I'll be back at between 4 and 5 p.m. my time for that. At the latest. So anyway... I will see you guys a little bit later. Bye. If this song will play, go figure it probably won't.